Praise the Lord, ladies and gentlemen. It is another day God has given to us. And we thank God for the gift of life. We come to you again live on Thursday. And we trust in God has kept you well up until now. And we trust that He will continue to take care of you. Because He is a loving God. And we are continuing with our series that we started on Tuesday. And I believe God is ministering to you. And the glory of God has started manifesting in your life. In Jesus' mighty name. And today we want to go a little further. And we see what happens when the glory of God is on you. And what provokes the glory of God to come. Number one, we saw that prayer that brings the glory of God. When we call upon God to come down, then His glory is revealed. And we receive the answers we are looking for. We receive the breakthrough we are deserving for. And He begins to change our circumstances. Because it is the joy of the Lord when He sees His children happy and their answers are given. Amen. And also we looked at the grace. The grace of God has the capacity to bring the glory of God. We can try to fight or to do things in our own strength. But sometimes we end somewhere where we cannot do anymore. And the grace of God takes over. I want to say to you today, we are what we are today by the grace of God. And that grace that God gave to us through Jesus Christ has revealed the glory of God. Amen. And now we want to look at another point that I believe is going to help you to understand the glory of God better. We want to look at the word vision. When you have the vision, a vision mostly is not only for you. It is for the assignment that God has called you for. So when the assignment is fulfilled, then the glory of God is revealed. So when you dream something and it comes to pass, as you begin to celebrate the achievement, then the glory of God is revealed. We want to look at Genesis today, chapter number 12. And looking at verses number 7. Genesis chapter number 12. And verse number 7. Here the Bible says, and the Lord appeared unto Abram. And he said, unto thy seed will I give this land. And there builded he an altar unto the Lord, who appeared unto him. As we continue going down, verse number 8. And he removed from the heaven unto the mountain of east of Bethel. And pitched his tent Having Bethel on the west and Hai on the east. And there he built an altar unto the Lord. And he called upon the name of the Lord. Now, ladies and gentlemen, after God appeared to Abraham in chapter number 12, I mean promising Abraham in chapter number 12, verse number 1. Then Abraham caused to build an altar. Begin to seek the vision giver. Because when God gives you a vision, He wants you to depend on Him for the fulfillment. Chapter number 12 from verses 1. Let's get there and see the picture. And see the picture of the whole matter here. Amen. Verses number 1, please. The same chapter, Genesis chapter. Yes. And now the Lord had said unto Abraham, get thee out of thy country. And from thy kindred. And from thy father's house. Unto the land that I will show thee. Now here God is giving Abraham a vision. And verse number 2, he says, I will make of thee a great nation. And I will bless thee. And I will make thy name great. And thou shalt be a blessing. Verse number 3 says, and thou bless them that bless thee. And thou curse him that curses thee. And in thee shall all the families of the earth be blessed. Brothers and sisters, here God is speaking to Abraham. And to him it sounds like a strange language. He is taking him to the people he has never known. He is planning to make him a great among the nations. Then out of him, he wants, through him, he wants to bless the entire world. Now Abraham, after hearing such a message, in verse number 7 we saw he built an altar. That whatever God has spoken can come to pass. I came to declare to you today that the vision you have, depending on the God who gave it to you, it shall come to pass. And the glory of God shall be revealed. What you saw in that vision, it may look to be bigger than your understanding. But when you depend on Jehovah and build an altar and seek Him for guidance, seek Him for wisdom, seek Him for direction, He will never let you down. And as that dream and vision comes to pass, the glory of God shall be revealed. And you shall begin to celebrate and say, what He said to me, I can see it today. What He spoke to me and showed me, now I can see it. Ladies and gentlemen, our God is not a liar. I'm going to show you your future. Is the the same God that is going to help you to get where you are going. Sometimes it looks like it is dark, where you cannot even see where you are going. Sometimes you begin to doubt. It was God that spoke to me, or it was my own understanding. It was God who showed me, or it was my imagination. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a journey of faith. That when God speaks, you believe His word. And when you believe His word, He will bring the manifestation of His glory. Oh, hallelujah. And here we see again in chapter 15 in the book of Genesis, looking at verses number 1. Remember, we are talking about the vision. Brings the glory. Your vision will bring the glory. When the vision is fulfilled, people begin to know you. Those who never knew you before, they begin to hear about you. Now the glory of God is revealed when you achieve what the Lord showed you in the vision. Chapter 15, Genesis, verse 1. After these things, the word of the Lord came to Abraham in a vision. We see God again comes to Abraham in a vision, saying, "Fear not, I am thy shield and thy exceeding great reward." Ladies and gentlemen, the God we serve comes to Abraham again. He says, "I am your shield and your exceeding great reward." And He tells him not to be afraid. Ladies and gentlemen, there are so many things out there that we can be afraid of. And we know that sometimes we don't have the ability and the capacity to handle them. But because God has said it, we shall achieve it. Because God has spoken it, we shall achieve it. By faith I declare, your vision shall arise. Your ministry will arise. Your business will arise. Your life will arise. Because God has said it, and it shall come to pass. Now Abraham, in that chapter, in chapter 15, he begins to question. He questions God in verse number 2. He says, what he is saying does not match with what he is. What God is speaking to Abraham is not matching with the condition of Abraham. And Abraham wonders. And he sees Abraham say, "Lord God, what will you give me? Seeing I go childless, and the steward of my house is this Eliezer of Damascus." Verse number 3. And he says, and Abraham said, "Behold, to me thou hast given me no seed, and lo, no one born in my house is my heir. And behold, the word of the Lord came unto him." He said, "This shall not be thine heir, but he that I shall come forth out of thine own bones." Shall be thine heir. Now Abraham is receiving the vision of becoming great, becoming the father of nations. And through him, God is going to bless the nation. himself. There is no way the word and his life come together. And now he begins to wonder, how am I going to become a fatherless when I go childless? When there is no child of my own, and the Lord comes back to him and he says, what I say to you shall come to pass. Probably you were in the same condition like Abraham. You have heard greater things about yourself, but you wonder, how is it going to happen? Looking at the circumstances and the environment does not connect with what you heard. My friend, the God who said it will make it happen. The God who declared it, he shall make it come to pass. And his glory shall be revealed. I don't know who I am talking to, but wherever you are, you must some come up and beg. Now, God is your father, you cannot take it. And you can talk to me, young man. End up in a battle. No one could never be in the situation around you. Abraham depended on God until the fulfillment of the vision he saw. Do not stop seeing your tomorrow, because your tomorrow is going to be greater than your yesterday. Do not stop prophesying. Do not stop confessing the greater things God has spoken. When you continue confessing them, speaking them, they'll become part of your life. I'm so excited, because your life is about to reach a turning point where what the Lord has spoken will begin to be revealed. Ladies and gentlemen, for sure, Abraham became the great man. He was the father of nations. What God spoke came to pass. And I declare unto you, what the Lord has spoken shall come to pass. Every limitation shall be destroyed. Every hindrance shall be removed. If you can only believe what the Lord has spoken. Sometimes we listen to voices of negativity, where the enemy says, you'll never mount up to anything. You'll never become anything. The devil is a liar. You shall become what God declared you to be. You shall achieve what God says you shall achieve. In the mighty name of Jesus. Before we go into prayer, I want us to go to Genesis number 28 and verses number 1. Genesis 28 and verses number 1. The Bible says, and Isaac called Jacob and blessed him and charged him and said unto him, thou shalt not take a wife of the daughters of Canaan. Now arise and go to Ramah, to the house of the Bethel, to the house of Bethel, thy mother's father, and take thee a wife from hence of the daughters of Laban, and thy mother's brother. Now this is a confirmation that the barrenness of Abraham was broken. Because now we see his son getting married. Hallelujah. His son Isaac commanding his son Jacob, which means come to pass. You have a dream of starting a ministry. Don't lose heart. You have a vision of starting business. Do not lose hope. You have a vision of traveling nations. The Lord will help you, and it shall come to pass. In the name of Jesus, I want to pray with you today. And I believe your vision will manifest the glory of God. We see thousands of people and millions of people around the world whose visions are accomplished, and the glory of God was revealed. I pray for you today that the glory of God shall be revealed in your life, manifested in every aspect of your life. Lord, I pray for the viewers and those that are watching us. Those, I pray that you reach them at the point of their need, that their visions and their dreams become a reality, and the glory of God will be manifested in Jesus' name. It's good to have you at this lunch of life. We shall be with you again tomorrow. God bless you. We love you and pray for you. This is Apostle J.K. Sekalala. Amen.